My name is EposVox, and today I'll be discussing some tips and tricks for improving your recording and streaming experience in the Elgato Game Capture HD software. I will have other tutorials on Elgato's capture cards and a plethora of other technology topics on my channel, so be sure to subscribe if you found this video helpful, and check the YouTube card icon above or the description down below for a playlist with my other Elgato gaming related videos. While game recording and streaming is becoming more mainstream than it has ever been, not everyone has a super powerful gaming or broadcasting capable computer. Elgato's USB capture devices are designed to work with most computers, but if your computer is struggling to keep up with the recording or streaming process, you will need to make some compromises with the settings and features of the software. Let's take a look at some tips to get the most performance out of the Game Capture HD software on your machine. Let's start with the basics. Close anything that you don't need open on your computer besides the Game Capture HD software. Heavy programs running in the background can heavily impact your recording or streaming performance. Bulky antivirus suites may need to be temporarily disabled while you're recording or streaming as well. Also, make sure your computer is up to date. Check for Windows or Mac updates, of course, but also make sure your graphics drivers are up to date. These can help quite a bit with recording performance. If you have an AMD or Nvidia graphics card, both companies provide easy driver updating tools, and I will link both in the description below. If you just have basic integrated graphics or you're not sure, you'll need to look up your computer's manufacturer's support page for update driver information. These are generally all pretty basic installers that are fairly easy to deal with. If you have a dedicated graphics card in your computer, using it for Elgato video encoding and decoding could get drastically better performance on your machine. To see if this is an option for you, click the settings gear in the very top right-hand corner of the software and click the advanced tab. Here, you have two drop-down menus and a slider. For the decoder and encoder drop-downs, see if you can choose something other than software. For example, I can choose my NVIDIA GTX 1080 graphics card for the encoding and decoding processes, which will perform much better than the software mode that only uses the basic CPU. If you cannot choose something other than software, or this doesn't entirely fix your problem, you can use the slider to find a sweet spot between getting the best performance out of the software and getting the highest quality recording. This should be the first thing you knock down before we mess with other settings. Elgato's Flashback recording and stream command tools are extremely powerful tools to enhance your streaming and recording experience, but this also means they require a lot of horsepower to use. Disabling these can also improve performance on your computer. To do so, click the settings gear in the top right-hand corner of the software and uncheck Enable Flashback Recording and/or Enable Stream Command and hit OK. Depending on where the bottleneck is in your system, you may only need to disable one of these, but definitely try disabling them if you're running into performance problems. One final way to help improve performance in the Elgato Game Capture HD software is to mess with the recording bitrate, video resolution, and video frame rate of your recordings. While on the Capture tab of the software, click the settings gear in the device box below the name of your device. Mine says Game Capture HD 60 Pro, but yours may differ. The settings here will be the same for everyone, however. The profile and quality settings are what you will need to play with. To lower resolution, change the drop-down menu from HD 1080 to HD 720 for 720p or standard for 480p. If you want to switch to only recording 30 FPS gameplay and have one of the HD profiles selected, simply uncheck Allow 60 FPS. I recommend playing with the resolution and bitrate first, however, as many slower machines can handle 720p 60 FPS fine, despite struggling with 1080p 60 FPS. The quality slider adjusts the recording bitrate or bandwidth. This is how much data is recording per second of footage. The closer to good you slide, the better performance you could see, but at the sacrifice of image cleanness. Play with these settings and find a sweet spot that works for you. I do hope this video has been helpful for you. If it has, high noon that like button. Get subscribed for more awesome tech videos and check out the description below. Down there, I have a link to the playlist with all of my Elgato gaming tutorials and reviews. Check them out. I also have product links to each Elgato card if you're looking to buy. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.